2007 study conducted by the National Endowment for the Arts discovered that only 48% of adult Americans read for pleasure. Now I know that probably doesn't mean anything to you guys or to most of you, but it's actually a huge blow for the reading culture. Today I brought a copy of Harper Lee's 1960s To Kill a Mockingbird. I've been reading since the sixth grade, and you know, so far I believe that this is my favorite book for, you know, many reasons. It's a great book. But yeah, I'm sure a lot of you are actually familiar with it. But if you're not, I'll just provide a really short, brief summary on it. The book is set in 1930s Alabama in a small town. It follows a young girl named Scout and her brother Jem as they try to make fun of the long, boring days in their little town. Meanwhile, their father Atticus is dealing with a very controversial racial case in the town's courtroom. And yeah, I hope that by listening to me speak, you guys gain a better understanding of this book and its significance to the reading culture, and just of the reading culture in general. I'll first be talking about the significance of the book to the reading culture and its value to my life. So I'll start off by saying that this book is actually widely popular, and it's used in a lot of English, high school English classrooms. That's where I first discovered it, I guess you could say. So yeah, it emphasizes education, I think it encourages students to read books. I know a lot of people don't enjoy reading books, but I think when teachers do that, they assign books to you in classrooms. It's not only does teach you lessons, you know, like learning about literary devices, like symbolism and things like that. I think they do it in hopes that you'll want to read things that interest you, because there's most likely a book on like any topic you can think of. So, but people tend to shy away from even going after books, looking for books and stuff like that. The book, it covers a lot of topics such as the relationships you have with people. It explores things like that. It explores things like relationships between family members, your friends, acquaintances, and even strangers. It offers a lot of life lessons that you wouldn't think that it would, because it's based in such an older time, but it's actually very relatable. It has a lot to do with your changing perceptions of people, and yeah, the book is very valuable, I think, to the culture, because it can mean many different things to many different people, like a lot of books do. You interpret things differently, everybody is different. So now I've talked about the significance of the book to the reading culture, and now I'll talk about its value to my life. I think that this is my favorite book because the relationship that Scout has with her father reminds me a lot of the relationship I have with my own father, or that I used to have when I was a little girl, because I had, you know, he was my hero, he was like, so yeah, but as I've grown older, I've realized a lot of things throughout the years, and the way that I view him has changed. And whenever I think about this book, I still think about, I see myself as a little girl, and I feel that love that I always have for my dad, even though things are different. This book, as well as other books and, you know, the reading culture, they've helped me find myself. When people ask me why I like to read, I always just give them a simple answer and just say it's fun. But in reality, I like to read because reading is like an escape from your own world. You know, you get to experience somebody else's life and somebody else's universe. And I think that has helped me appreciate my own life and my own reality. And I think that's very important because, you know, sometimes you just hate your life, I guess you can say. But then, I don't know, things change when you start to appreciate who you are and where you come from and things like that. And also I want to be a writer, I want to be an author and things like that. And I wrote my first published article on To Kill a Mockingbird, so I owe a lot to this book, I feel. Okay, so I've talked about the significance of this book to the reading culture and its value to my life, and now I'm going to conclude everything that I'm talking about by saying that I hope that now you guys have a better understanding of the reading culture and of books in general and of this book. And yeah, don't be afraid of books because they're probably more afraid of you than you are of them, so just give them a chance.